राइट, आई हैड ट्राइड एक लिमिटर फंक्शन यूज करने को एंड एडेड सम थ्रेशोल्ड, अ वेरी पॉपुलर ब्रांड, वन आई थिंक वुड बी वन ऑफ द बेस्ट सेलिंग ब्रांड्स इन इन टुडेज मार्केट इन इंडिया फॉर अ डीएसपी, बट उसमें लिमिटर फंक्शन, मे बी देव करेक्टेड दिस फैक्ट बिफोर बिकॉज आई सॉ लॉट ऑफ पीपल इवन कंप्लेनिंग अबाउट इट ऑनलाइन. और यू नो थ्रेशोल्ड, इफ यू आप सिग्नल पास करते थे, जो थ्रेशोल्ड सेट करने के बावजूद वो थ्रेशोल्ड के ऊपर वो सिग्नल को पास करने देता था, एंड even something like a square wave would pass through very easily. So always check your processors, it's a good idea. Check your, that's what I said, get familiar with your equipment, see what is happening, and just get an idea of what you're exactly doing. So I'm just going to quickly get into measurements right now. Let me see if I have, just to cover some few things on this thing before we actually get into measurements. We've covered crossovers, and we also use parametric EQs. Parametric EQs mein kya hai? Ye graphic EQ mein kya hota hai ki aapka jo center frequency hai, agar 31 band ka graphic EQ hai, to aapke alag alag 31 alag alag frequencies hai, jiska wo frequency fixed hai. You can change the gain and or you attenuate it. That's up to you. Jo slider hai uska attenuate kar sakte hai. The Q is fixed as well. But of course, it's proportional because Q factor is dependent on frequency. Q jo hai aapka jo filter hai, I'll just show it to you right now again on this thing. It basically determines how wide or narrow your high Q EQ filter would probably use as a notch filter. Aapko kuch frequency cut karna hai. Aur yahan hum parametric equalizer use kar rahe hain, jahan you can have variable jo frequency hai, alag alag frequency pe kar sakte hai. You can have the gain again varying plus and minus, and you can change the jo aapke filter ki chaudai hai, you can have it narrow or wide or however you want it. And again, we showed this delay locator. And lastly, because we're going to be coming to the topic of aligning subwoofers with the tops, which is most common. Bahut log chahte hai ki hum apne subwoofer ko tops ke sath align kare. It's basically a geometric diagram, और कुछ नहीं है, क्योंकि ये जो डिस्टेंस है, it's wherever you stand, आपका हमेशा एक आपसे सबूफर से आप तक दूरी और लाइनर से आप तक दूरी, जैसे या पूरे जो लिसनिंग प्लेन में आप बदलते जाएंगे, वहाँ आपका ये जो लाइन, जो रेड लाइन है और ब्लू लाइन है, उसके बीच को जो डिफरेंस है वो हमेशा बदलते जाएगा. सो इफ यू आर अलाइनिंग एट वन प्लेस, you'll always find some time difference at some other place, or you know, it changes vice versa. As you go farther into the field, jaise aap aur dur jate gaye, ye dono lal line aur blue line lagbhag unke beech ka jo difference hai wo kam hote jayega aur wo kafi bade area tak same rahega. To isko aapko kahan align karna hai, that is a decision that you have to make. And there are many people align it at the FOH position. The way I usually like to align it, but again, for big fields, many people have a theory that you should align at maybe about something more than half the venue, maybe at about 60-70%. So my rule is, I usually divide, if it's a very long, listening plane, yeah, aapka lamba ground hai, I usually divide the ground into three parts. I go into the third part, and probably the center of the third part, I see the, the difference between, or whatever the difference I'm getting between the main and the subs. Again, if it's within the area that this line area and subwoofer is covering. Agar aapka ground hai bahut lamba aur usme suppose 40 meter pe aapne ek delay stack use kiya hai, ya 50 meter pe aapne delay stack use kiya hai, I would be dividing 50 meters into 3, and probably in the last 16 meters stand somewhere in the center at probably around 40 meters and measure. And just at the crossover frequency, agar mera crossover frequency is, let's say, maybe about 100 hertz, I would kind of see what is the time period of 100 hertz. Let's say the time period of 100 hertz is about 10 milliseconds. So 10 milliseconds, and I know that the, I don't want to complicate you guys much, but what Rajesh said is that you have phase addition when the phase, the phase difference between two signals is 0 degrees to 120 degrees. And as you grow from 0 to 120, jaise aap 0 se 120 ke phase difference pe jaate hai, addition kam hote jata hai. So within a 60 degree window, so let's say 60 upon 360 is about one sixth of the time period of 10 milliseconds would be, that's if ye agar aapka 100 hertz ka crossover frequency hai. One sixth of 10 milliseconds would be roughly about 1.8, 1.9. So jo bhi aapka jo delay value aapko milega in that area where you're measuring, I would delay it further by about 1.6 milliseconds. So what happens is, अगर मैं सबवूफर को वो एरिया में 1.6 से ज्यादा डिले करूं, वो पॉइंट पे आपका लाइन एरे जो है वुड बी लीडिंग, आपका वो पॉइंट पे लाइन एरे, एंड अगेन द डिफरेंस वुड बी जस्ट विद इन 60 डिग्री, सो अगेन आई वुड हैव मोर और लेस एडिशन. और जैसे ही मैं स्टेज की तरफ बढ़ते जाऊंगा, एट सम पॉइंट वो दोनों का जो लाइन है वो दोनों लगभग इक्वल होते जाएगा. तो एट सम पॉइंट इन द मिडिल बिटवीन 0 meters एंड 40 meters, आई वुड प्रॉब्ली गेट 0 degrees phase difference, and I would have maximum addition. And as you would grow closer and closer to the stage, wo point pe your subwoofers would start leading again by maybe a few milliseconds here and there. And then you would again be within a good window of a good addition between your line area and the sub. But it's just that jo aapka center point, jo jahan aapka maximum phase difference zero hai, uske piche aapke line area ka thoda lead karenge. और उसके आगे जो है आपके सबवूफर थोड़े लीड करेंगे. और अगर आपने बहुत ही वेन्यू के या स्टेज के सामने आपने अलाइन किया, तो जैसे आप वो पॉइंट से पीछे जाते गए वो पॉइंट के बाद आपको आपके लाइनर वो पॉइंट से लीड करते जाएंगे. सो जस्ट टू कीप अ वेरी इवन बैलेंस, आई डोंट वांट टू गेट इन टू मच कॉम्प्लिकेशन बिकॉज मेक वी गेट कंफ्यूजिंग एंड वी हैव वेरी लिटिल टाइम. इज जस्ट समथिंग आई डू. दोज़ हु आर मेजरिंग, एवरीवन हैज देयर ओन ways to approach this. This is one of the ways I approach it. So I'm just going to, within the next 15-20 minutes, try and get a measurement. So I'm going to close hamara jo PowerPoint hai. I'm going to switch back. Instead of my processor, I'm going to move back to my microphone input. So just give me a second. And I'm going to switch off my delay finder. And जो हमारा प्रोसेसर है, मैं चैनल 5 को म्यूट करूंगा एंड आई एम जस्ट गोना अनम्यूट. इफ आई अनम्यूट, डू यू गेट, डू यू हियर द पिंक नॉइस?
यस यस.
ओके, सो आई एम नॉट गोना टॉक व्हेन द पिंक नॉइस, आई जस्ट टेक अ मेजरमेंट एंड देन टॉक आफ्टर वी टेक द मेजरमेंट. ओके, सो just to give you guys a brief idea in terms of what we have done, I switched on my mic, I unmuted the channel, we had a pink noise running, and if I can just show you with music for that matter. So anything that I can show you that it's kind of showing a similar response for those who are confused that you need to use pink noise or anything. So anything that has So you guys could see I have a almost an identical phase and magnitude. So it really doesn't depend whether we are really working on music or pink noise or whatever. But since people just love pink noise, we're going to just stick to pink noise. But you can see mere do measurement hai with music and with pink noise was pretty similar. If I can kind of just look at my signal, and if I also want to kind of see my Linkwitz-Riley low-pass filter, or sorry, high-pass filter at 100 hertz, this is the kind of response I should be getting. So if you high-pass the tops at maybe 100 hertz, जो सोचते हैं कि अगर मैंने यहाँ 100 हर्ट्ज का हाई पास फिल्टर लगा के अगर मेरे को लगभग ऐसा फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज मिल जाएगा, आई कैन एक्चुअली जस्ट लेट मी ऑफसेट दिस अ बिट, जस्ट होल्ड ऑन. या सो अगर आपको लगता है कि आपको लगभग अगर 100 हर्ट्ज का हाई पास फिल्टर लगा के जो हमारा कर्व है उसके जैसे मिलेगा, तो इट्स नॉट करेक्ट. बिकॉज व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग, अगर आप अपने स्पीकर पे हाई पास फिल्टर लगा रहे हैं, you're actually getting a combination of the box's response, a box ka bhi har ek phase response or a roll off hai, and then your processor is adding its own DSP, which is the curve that you see out here. So when you add a high pass filter to your box, the final result, jo aapko final result milega, will always be a combination of the box as well as a DSP, matlab box ka port ka रोल ऑफ, स्पीकर के कंपोनेंट का रोल ऑफ, एंड समथिंग ऑफ योर डीएसपी. सो इफ आई जस्ट सिंपली एड हाई पास फिल्टर ऑफ, लेट्स से दिस आउटपुट 3, एंड इफ आई यूज अ हाई पास फिल्टर ऑफ 100 हर्ट्ज एंड यूज अ Linkwitz-Riley, दिस वाज 24 dB एन ऑक्टेव. होल्ड ऑन, व्हाई इज इट स्टक? Okay, so if I now measure it, I'm going to quickly just again for everyone's fun use pink noise. You can see that there's a little more energy I'm getting if I'm, you know, offsetting jo hamara curve, if I'm offsetting it to around somewhere on the flat line, I'm getting some more energy in the roll off region, and that's again because of the box response that you will be getting. So something to get something similar, I would probably use, again this is out of experience of that what I use, I would probably use around 125 to kind of see if I get a similar response. So this is something that I would use probably around 125. And again, I wanted to show you guys. So let me just quickly just, move back and show you what happens when you EQ. So I'm going to go and mute this and unmute. Just let me show you the what happens when you add EQ. Just hold on.
Karan, can you just get your coherence trace on in smart before you start EQing?
Okay. Just hold on. Where is it? What's the this thing?
CC. Just hit C.
Oh, just hit C. Okay. Okay, let me just show the processor first. So this is output 5, and why is my measured signal not showing? Just hold on. Is it, oh, it's muted, sorry. Okay, here we go. Okay. I'm using a, let me again just insert the delay. As you can see, let me just, you know, remove the high pass filter at all completely. And sorry, low pass filter completely. So this is output 5 and this is no cutoff. Now I should be getting, after inserting, my measured signal is quite high, so I'm going to reduce it a bit and increase my reference signal a little. Yeah. So as you can see, you're getting a pretty, you're getting a pretty flat magnitude and phase response. It's a little higher because of my measurement signal is a little higher, but I want to show you that if you add an EQ, so let's say I'm adding any EQ, let's say it's 250 Hertz. I'm just going to add an EQ, which is, a wide one. So that's, let's say 1. And if I go back to smart, you can see my phase response is no longer flat. Magnitude, of course, we expected the magnitude to change, but the phase is no longer flat either. The jo iska karan main jo main kyun bata raha hu, kyunki aap jab bhi do cheezon ko equalize karenge, wo box ka aapko EQ jo bhi hai, whenever you are adding a crossover with a subwoofer, uske jo default EQ hai, jo system EQ hai, wo subwoofer ke sath summation karne ke pehle aap EQ at least please kar lijiye, kyunki agar aap wo karne ke baad aap EQ karenge box ko, to uska phase response wapas change hoga. So we are going to do the output EQs before we combine it with the sub. So I'm just going to come back to my response, which is here, and again do a live measurement. So I'm just going to put my speaker again. Just hold on. Okay. So I'm going to kind of just show you what, we're just not going to use this channel anymore. So I'm muting this and you're using channel 3 again.
It's not seeing your mic signal.
What's that?
It's not seeing your mic signal.
Yeah, I'm just, because I'm not switched on my 48 volt phantom power. Just hold on.
Oh, okay.
So something that I will be keeping on doing, I'll be keeping on adding some parametric EQs and you guys can just watch. So one option would be to keep muting and going back and forth, but I'll just try and do it on the go so that it's like visible to everyone and we can just do it quickly. It's not something big, but again, one more thing is parametric EQs, I usually prefer to just kind of cut rather than gain anything. I don't gain much in practice because you need to be absolutely dead sure. In a basic session, I would want to explain that you have to be absolutely sure that jo aapka response ka dip hai, it's from the speaker and not because of some acoustic cancellation. If it is against some acoustic cancellation and no matter how much you keep boosting those frequencies, aap sirf wo speaker ke voice coil ko garam kar rahe aur kuch nahi. So as much as possible, try not to boost anything, rather just kind of try and cut all the peaks, which is a lot safer for you rather than boosting something. Because agar koi cheez acoustic cancellation ki wajah se hai, aap usko jitna bhi boost karenge wo wahi ka wahi rahega aur sirf aap speaker ko aur garam kar rahe ho aur kuch nahi, aur wo aapke speaker ke value ko aur speaker ko aur danger mein dal raha hai, udne ke chance mein dal raha hai. So I'm just going to quickly do some few things basically, just switching it on and this is basically P. Just done a basic EQ for my this thing. We could fine tune it later, but for the HF, for those who feel that the level is less, we'll be using the high shelving in the input to just kind of give it a boost from 2K onwards to just increase the level by a few dB. But just to kind of capture this and say EQ top. So I have my EQ top, where I've cut some peaks, and I'm just going to go quickly onto the sub as well. I don't know. And as you can see, it's a very gentle this thing. Nothing too aggressive, where it's like -8 or -10 or something. It's extremely gentle. And if I just, I'm going to keep the delay time the same right now. And probably just look at the response of the subwoofer first. So I'll just unmute the sub.
Karan, there's just one thing I want to add here.
Yeah.
Okay. Like for everyone, it's not that we go on to EQ a system just at one position or something. This is just for, he's showing you for demonstration how a EQ works and how you can see that. So yeah. Because the coherence is down, it's like, you know, there are questions, why is it that way? So this is just for demonstration so that you know what is happening. Otherwise, when we actually system EQ a system, we have multiple mic positions, we take averages, and then we decide. It is not as simple as just putting an EQ and notching it down.
Yep. So okay. Since we have only this thing one, we're just going to try and see and then change the position and average. Oh, we're already at 430, but so I'm just going to quickly show you a subwoofer. I'm just going to kind of hide my this thing and go back to my subwoofer. And so I'm going to be giving, remember that Butterworth has an extra bump. So I always prefer to give my high pass filter on the subwoofer. Or hamesha subwoofer ko hum high pass filter lagate to prevent it against subharmonic frequencies, to prevent over excursion, jo aapka HF, jo aapka LF ka woofer hai, usko over excursion se protect karne ke liye, ek high pass filter around 25 se 30 years dena bahut hi helpful hai. And so I'm just going to give something at around 30. You may not hear the sub, but again, the reason why I've chosen about 90 is because if my 100 hertz of low pass filter 24 dB is roughly looking like this, is my this thing offset? Yeah, it's offset. So yeah, so this is what my 0 dB is going to be. Or ye jo subwoofer mere ghar ka band pass subwoofer hai. So I'm seeing some kind of resonance at around 85, 86 hertz, and that's the frequency at which I tuned the port. So I'm just going to kind of reduce it a bit, just to give you a brief idea for within like 2 minutes as to what we are doing. Just hold on. So I'm going to go back and probably, and even at where you see this at about 150, you're seeing again another peak out of the subwoofer response. So this is why I'd briefly just measured this at 150, and it's not going to be affecting my passband too much. And this is at about 80, 85. And yeah, I've chosen 83 out here. So and just to give some more enhancement, you'll see a lot of white papers on a lot of brands that they enhance some of the frequency on the sub between, especially between the 50 to 60 area, to kind of give you this extra bump feeling. So I'm just going to show you what that is. Just hold on. Yeah, so I've chosen about 65 and probably about 4 dB, just to give you this extra bump and attack that you would feel. Now if I see my face, let me just capture this. This is EQ sub. Okay. Now if you see the phase difference here, I'm right now measuring in my ground plane. I usually, many people I know align their subs and tops in the ground plane, but that's okay in a large field. But somewhere when something like my hall, jo mera ghar ka hall hai, I usually prefer to do alignment and kind of room equalization by keeping it the way the system is going to be held and keeping my mic at probably my ear height, because that's where the sound from the subwoofer and the sound from the tops is going to come. So I'm just going to jo hamara jo mic hai jo niche rakha hai, speaker jo niche rakha hai, I'm just going to put it on the stand and come back and just switch on both, and so you can see, and then we can align or delay accordingly. Just give me 30 seconds.
Rajesh, maybe you want to just quickly talk about the coherence part.
Yep.
A few people were asking about that. When Karan was taking the measurements, we could see that probably in the low mid range, the coherence was a bit low. Whereas in the highs and high mid, it was pretty decent. So, yeah, Rajesh, even this.
ये इतना आसान नहीं कि बस माइक एक लगा दो और इक्यू कर लो. आपको कंसिडर करना पड़ता है कि आप कौन से एनवायरनमेंट में है और सब कुछ. तो बिकॉज अभी करण उसके घर पे है, आसपास बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जहां से रिफ्लेक्शंस आ रहे हैं, या अभी जो मोस्टली उसका सब वूफर जो है आई थिंक किसी वॉल के पास है, तो बहुत सारे रिफ्लेक्शंस डिपेंडिंग ऑन यू नो देयर आर लॉट ऑफ फैक्टर्स एंड दैट्स व्हाई द कोहेरेंस इज गोइंग डाउन. दिस इज नॉट द आइडियल बट दिस इज जस्ट टू गिव एन आइडिया. सो don't take any wrong messages that you know coherence niche hai fir bhi hum log EQ kar rahe hai. We are just trying to show ki EQ kaise kaam karta hai.
Yeah, it also basically tells you that the reason for that discrepancy in the frequency response, maybe one certain frequency is boosted or a certain frequency is very low, the coherence tells you that maybe it is not only a electronic issue, maybe it is not just the signal has a thing, maybe there is some, like some acoustic issue also due to reflection.
Yes.
So you can, yes. You need to just consider
something that is not in the signal, it is not in the reference signal, it is an external factor. Yeah, might be current ghar pe hai, to shayad aas paas se kuch awaaze aa rahi hai, koi baatein kar raha hai, kuch bhi ho sakta hai. There can be 100 reasons for that happening.
Okay, I will just quickly show the just hold on. So now since I've moved my speaker on a stand and the mic on a stand, then I'm just
Karan, just a minute.
Yeah.
I want the measurement. Can I annotate? How do I? Okay. Annotate. अभी एक चीज मुझे आपको बतानी है यहाँ पे, आप देखना इसके इम्पल्स रिस्पॉन्स में आप ओके कलर. How do I change color format? Okay.
In that, yeah, yeah. Format, yeah.
देखो ये एक impulse है. Okay.
You can't move it. You, yeah, it's a bit of a. हाँ.
ये एक impulse है. अरे क्या आ रहा है?
No, he is zoomed in.
Okay, cool. That's it. So this is one impulse. This is another impulse. This is one more. Then there is a reflection that is coming away. तो ये बहुत, ये आसपास बहुत कुछ चीजें हैं जहां से साउंड टकरा के वापस आ रहा है. दैट इज व्हाई ऑल दिस कोहेरेंस इज गोइंग डाउन. सो दिस इंपल्स रिस्पॉन्स इज बेसिकली टेलिंग यू देयर आर मोर रिफ्लेक्शन एंड दैट इज द रीजन ओवर हियर. सो इफ आई एक्चुअली पुट माय पुट अ कर्सर हियर, करण कैन यू पुट योर कर्सर देयर एट द फर्स्ट पीक?
या
द नेक्स्ट वन. तो अगर आप ये सेक्शन यहाँ पे देखोगे 0.46 मिलीसेकंड, ये क्या है, हाँ 2 मिलीसेकंड, तो ये बेसिकली बता रहा है कि आपके मेन इम्पल्स और रिफ्लेक्शन के बीच में 2 मिलीसेकंड का डिफरेंस है. सो देयर इज समथिंग विच इज एट अराउंड 2 फीट फ्रॉम वेयर थिंग्स आर रिफ्लेक्टिंग. सिमिलरली इधर आगे भी आई थिंक दिस इज अनदर 2 फीट. सो दीज आर मल्टीपल रिफ्लेक्शन बेसिकली. ओके कूल, यू कैन गो अहेड.
ओके, सो आई एम जस्ट गोना कैप्चर दिस and say and I'm also going to go and measure my subwoofer and switch that on. I'm going to capture this and say subwoofer. And we're going to see that both of them have the level is somewhere low, but like we expected, like a target area, the crossovers around this 100 hertz is what we are kind of expecting. If I am to say that between the sub and the top, I think the mid-high is this thing. The subwoofer is lagging behind the top because you see it is a lot more steeper and the top is a lot more shallower, which means I probably need to delay my top a little to kind of align it with the subwoofer at this current position. Now, if I am able to kind of connect the dots somewhere around the crossover region, you're seeing that the top is showing something like we are right now on the subwoofer, right? So, oh, sorry, mid-top. So, mid-top is showing about minus 92 and, sorry. And it is probably showing on the crossover region is maybe about Rajesh, any idea why is this line coming broken?
It's a reflection. This is a reflection.
Okay, so
you can see the coherence. Yeah, drop down drastically over here.
Okay, so we can just move it a little on the side and seeing that I'm getting probably around this is the subwoofer, which is about in this region I'm getting basically about 100 degrees odd, and the mid top I'm getting is probably minus 90. So 100 plus or minus 9, which would be basically about approximately 3 to 4 milliseconds off the cycle at 100 hertz. So if I'm going to probably look at just seeing the delays, and if I'm seeing the top is a lot more steeper, let's say if I add 4 milliseconds on the top, let me just measure the top first.
Varun,
yeah.
Do you want me to do it here? Because it seems that in your room now we are getting a lot of reflections. So might be people are getting a bit confused with those reflections.
If you can do it quickly, yeah, sure.
Yeah, you just carry on. Just give me 2 seconds so that I just get the setup ready.
Okay. So just to show you guys that it's just the purple trace is the pink trace is probably my subwoofer, and it's moving a little behind my subwoofer. So I'm just gonna get this to probably be, it's almost in the phase traces are almost matching in this crossover region that you see out here. If I'm going to be just highlighting this area. I would want them to kind of overlap in this region. There is some broken line here, and that is probably because of some reflection. But if I'm just using this left one as a reference, they're pretty much overlapping, and I can just play around a little with the delay by adding plus minus 0.1 milliseconds. And so I would expect maybe 3.2 milliseconds is what I'm getting in terms of overlapping. And if I kind of play them together, Nitesh, had I changed my delay when the speaker is mounted on this thing? Oh yeah, but it's delayed by 3 milliseconds is why I'm getting it. Sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Karan, do you want me to just show it here?
Yeah, you can.
You done with this thing?
The overall response is fine. I just need to, in a crossover region, I just need to check in terms of the actual delay value and the between the mid, high and the sub. But
okay,
yeah,
okay.
Go ahead and thing. But I'll just...
Cool. I'll just show
and just check it out. But you can kind of show it on your screen on your setup.
Will do. Whoa, what is it that you can see right now? Is my smart screen seen? No. Okay. 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 My smart screen is seen, right? Okay. So I'll first measure my HF